Hey guys, welcome back. I am Ashish and today we'll be continuing with our comparative public administration module. And we have done with ecological approach, we are done with structural functional approach, and we are also done with history and purpose scope of CPA and whatnot. So if you have not watched those sessions, please watch them first. Link for the playlist of this module of comparative public administration will be in the description of this video. So go ahead and watch them first and continuing with our models of comparative public administration today. So there are various classifications, various approaches have been suggested by different writers. And these are the approaches that are given by Farrell Heady. So we will not be studying these approaches. These are some other approaches given by Henderson. We will not be studying these approaches also. What we will be studying are approaches given by Ramesh K. Arora. Now Ramesh K. Arora is an Indian thinker who has written on comparative public administration. In the opinion of Ramesh K. Arora, the categories of Heady and Henderson are quite broad and overlapping. So the categories given by Heady and Henderson are quite broad and they are overlapping in nature. However, this is not to deny their utility of their classification. There are two basic approaches in CPA studies according to Ramesh K. Arora. He says that the approaches that Heady and Henderson gave, they are too broad and they overlap with each other, but he does not deny their utility. They are still useful in comparing the administrations, but he gave two basic approaches or two theories instead of four and three. He gave two basic approaches, universalist and ecological approach. Now ecological approach, we have studied what ecological approach is. In this session we will see what variations of ecological approach are used in comparative public administration. We know the overall nature of ecological approach, right? We have studied what ecological approach is in general. In this session we will study what variations of ecological approach are used in CPA. And another approach that Ramesh K. Arora gives is universalist approach, and he gives this two approach because he feels that approaches given by Heady and Henderson are too broad and overlapping. We will see this also in our future slides, that this development oriented approach and general system approach that you are seeing here, development oriented and general system, these approaches come under ecological approach. So like we have generalized these into two basic things, and under these things we will study different other things. So universalist approach and ecological approach. Now what does this universalist approach mean? As I have said to you many times before, in public administration things are what they look and sound like. So here universalist approach means something that is universal in nature, something which takes into account many countries of the world, you know. So it is universal in nature, which can be applied to any country at any time. So such kind of universalist approaches given by some thinkers, that comes under universalist approach and then ecological approach. So moving on with our universalist approach. The universalist approach seeks to find certain commonalities among public bureaucracies in various countries in the world by conceptual means. This approach is illustrated by Weber's bureaucratic model and Wilson's transfer of administrative practices model. So Wilson's approach we have studied about in two places. First, when we studied about Woodrow Wilson in module 1, we have studied what Woodrow Wilson said about comparative public administration. Also, when we were studying about history of public administration in this module itself, in module 7 itself, when we were studying about history, we have studied about Wilson's model. So please go back and watch those sessions. We have covered this earlier, we will not be covering this again. Wilson's approach of comparative public administration we have dealt with already. Bureaucratic model of Weber also we have dealt with, but we will see how it is specifically applied in CPA. We will see that today. So Weber's bureaucratic model, we have seen this, that Weber's concept of bureaucracy compares the forms of domination or authority. So he compares different types of authority or domination. This is nothing but tradition, charisma and legal rationality. Traditional authority, charismatic authority and legal rational type of authority. So these type of authorities he compares. Each form of domination or authority has its matching type of administrative staff. So whatever type of authority you take, you have a matching type of administrative staff. Traditional type of authority will have a traditional type of administrative staff. तो उसी तरह का आपको matching type मिलता है, centralized हो या decentralized हो, जिस तरह की आप authority उठाओगे उस तरह का आपको administrative staff भी मिल जाएगा. Bureaucracy is the form of administrative staff associated with legal rational authority. We have seen this, how Max Weber have defined bureaucracy. He defined bureaucracy as something associated with legal rational authority. So legal rational authority ka jo administrative staff hoga, usko hum bureaucracy bolenge. This is what Max Weber said. And this bureaucracy is capable of attaining the highest degree of efficiency. This also we have seen when we studied about Max Weber, that bureaucracy can achieve highest degree of efficiency. He believed this. This type of model is helpful in analysis of public and private organization in modern state. So this is how it comes in picture in CPA एबिलिटी है, यू नो, कंपेरेटिव पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में इस तरह से पिक्चर में आता है, वी कैन एनालाइज पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. फॉर एग्जांपल, हाउ क्लोज इंडियन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज टू वेबर्स मॉडल ऑफ आइडियल टाइप ब्यूरोक्रेसी, हाउ क्लोज यूएसए'ज एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम इज टू वेबर्स आइडियल टाइप ब्यूरोक्रेसी. सो ये सब हम कंपेयर कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पे कंपेरेटिव अप्रोच काम आती है वेबर्स मॉडल की. वी कैन कंपेयर एंड एनालाइज पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. वेबर्स आइडियल टाइप इज एसेंशियली यूजफुल एज अ टूल फॉर क्रॉस कल्चरल एंड हिस्टोरिकल स्टडीज. तो आप क्रॉस कल्चरल स्टडीज भी कर सकते हो एंड हिस्टोरिकल स्टडीज भी आप कर सकते हो. दिस इज हाउ इट इज हेल्पफुल, वेबर्स ब्यूरोक्रेटिक मॉडल इन कंपेयरिंग द पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. मोरो बर्गर, ही इज अ सीपीए स्कॉलर, कंपेरेटिव पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के स्कॉलर हैं मोरो बर्गर. ही यूज द ब्यूरोक्रेटिक मॉडल इन इज वर्क ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेसी एंड सोसाइटी इन मॉडर्न इजिप्ट, एंड दिस इज हाउ इट हैज बीन यूज. दिस इज वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेटिक मॉडल बींग यूज इन कंपेरेटिव पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. रॉबर्ट फ्राइड, ही इज अनदर scholar of CPA. He has made interesting comparison between rich bureaucracies and poor bureaucracies. He compared between rich and poor bureaucracies by keeping in mind Weber's model. So this is the another example of using Weber's model in comparing bureaucracies and administrations. Other thinkers like Diamond, Farrell, Hardy and Crozier have adopted bureaucratic model in their studies. They concluded that bureaucratic structure has been functioning differently in different Afro-Asian countries. So this is, they have concluded that this is the third example that many thinkers have used bureaucratic model in comparing administrations across countries and across cultures. Now we'll see some disadvantages of using this model in comparing administrations. So there are some disadvantages. We have studied this in criticisms of Max Weber also, and same criticisms apply here. There are some criticisms also when we use this model in comparing administration. So Weber's bureaucratic model is useful to explain the structural similarities between the bureaucracies of the developed nations of Europe and North America, but it is of little analytic value for explaining bureaucratic problems in the developing कंट्रीज ऑफ एशिया एंड अफ्रीका. तो आप डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज के लिए तो इसको अच्छे से यूज कर सकते हो कंपेयर करने के लिए. यूरोप एंड नॉर्थ अमेरिका के अगर आपको सोसाइटीज को कंपेयर करना है तो आप अच्छे से कंपेयर कर सकते हो. बट इफ यू हैव टू कंपेयर डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज ऑफ एशिया एंड अफ्रीका, देन देर इज नॉट मच एनालिटिक वैल्यू इन दिस मॉडल ऑफ मैक्स वेबर. इट मे बी एडिक्वेट फॉर एन ऑनगोइंग ब्यूरोक्रेसी, बट इट कैन नॉट डील विद प्रॉब्लम्स अराइजिंग फ्रॉम डेवलपमेंट एंड नेशन बिल्डिंग इन द थर्ड वर्ल्ड. तो जो ऑनगोइंग ब्यूरोक्रेसी है, जो डेवलप्ड नेशंस हो चुके हैं ऑलरेडी, जिनकी ब्यूरोक्रेसी ऑलरेडी चल रही है, आप उनको कंपेयर करना तो आप कर सकते हो. इट मे बी एडिक्वेट फॉर एन ऑनगोइंग ब्यूरोक्रेसी, बट ब्यूरोक्रेसी विच इज बिल्डिंग अप, जो एकदम इनिशियल स्टेजेस में है, विच इज इन द फेज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट एंड नेशन बिल्डिंग इन द थर्ड वर्ल्ड, यू कैन नॉट डील विद सच ब्यूरोक्रेसीज यूजिंग दिस मॉडल. दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ यूजिंग दिस मॉडल इन कंपेयरिंग पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशंस. वेबर्स ब्यूरोक्रेटिक मॉडल ऑल्सो लैक्स एलिमेंट्स यूजफुल टू एक्सप्लेन ह्यूमन बिहेवियर विद इन अ ब्यूरोक्रेटिक एनवायरमेंट, एंड वी हैव स्टडीड दिस दैट बिहेवियरल अप्रोच एंड ह्यूमन रिलेशंस अप्रोच, व्हाई दीज अप्रोचेस केम टू राइज, बिकॉज ट्रेडिशनल अप्रोचेस विच वर यूज by Max Weber and all the other thinkers, these traditional approaches did not deal with human behavior. So you cannot explain human behavior across nations, across countries. If you are comparing public administration, it is important that you compare human behavior also, right? So you cannot explain human behavior using Max Weber's model. This is another disadvantage of using Weber's model in comparing public administrations. However, Dwight Waldo, we know who Dwight Waldo is, he is related to new public administration, right? So Dwight Waldo found the bureaucratic model useful, stimulating and provocative. So he has praised Weber's bureaucratic model and he has found this model useful. And he said that no model in the study of CPA provides clearer and more precise guidelines than Weber's bureaucratic ideal type. Because Weber gave out some ideal type features, right? Features of an ideal type of bureaucracy. So Dwight Waldo says that no model in CPA gives so much clear guidelines of comparing things, because these are very clear and precise guidelines. You can compare things very easily. These are very clear and precise features, he says, and this is why he finds this model useful and stimulating and provocative. So this is what is Weber's bureaucratic model in comparative public administration, and Wilson's model we have already studied, we will not discuss that again. So these are the two basic approaches in universalist approach. So I hope it is clear to you how these are universalist approach, right? That they can be applied to any country in the world. You can compare any administration by comparing how close they are to Weber's model or Wilson's theory. So this is like a universal thing that you can apply anywhere and you can compare any administration. There are some drawbacks to both of these theories. Weber ke bhi drawback hai, Wilson ke bhi drawback hai, but still the fact remains that these are universal approaches. You can apply them anywhere and everywhere. So these are the two universal approaches. We are done with universal approach. Remember, there were two approaches of comparative public administration. and the second approach is nothing but our ecological approach. And we are done with ecological approach in general, what in general ecological approach is, right? We'll briefly touch upon that in this slide. So it signifies the interconnections between an administrative system and its social, political, economic and cultural environment. So ye jo bhi factors hain environment ke, social factor, political, cultural and economic factors, all these factors are interconnected to administrative system, and we study these interconnections in ecological approach. We are done with this in our ecological session. In other words, this theory is concerned with the interaction between an administrative system and its external environment. तो हर administrative system का उसके external environment के साथ क्या interaction है वो हम study करते हैं. How an administrative system operates in practice will be determined by its environmental conditions. तो जिस तरह के environmental conditions होंगे वो affect करेगा how your administration operates. So how an administrative system operates will be affected by your environmental conditions. Also public administration also affects its environment. तो खाली environment affect नहीं करता, public administration also affects its environment. We have dealt with this in detail in our ecological approach session. So it is a bi-directional thing. It is not a unidirectional thing that only environment affects administration. It is a bi-directional things. Both affect each other. According to ecological theory, public bureaucracies throughout the world show great diversity because of variations in their environmental settings. So there are different cultures across the world, there are different traditions across the world, and therefore there are different environments in which these administrations are placed. So because of these variations in environmental settings, public bureaucracies all over the world will be different. So that is why administration in one part of the globe will be different from another part of the globe. We have dealt with this also. The strong advocate of ecological model is none other then our Fred W. Ricks. We'll study about Fred W. Ricks in our next session. So he is the main proponent of ecological approach in CPA, and he's also called as the father of CPA. Other important proponents of this theory are John M. Goss. We have studied about John M. Goss and his views also in ecological approach. We have studied about Robert Dahl also. We have studied about Robert Dahl in behavioral approach and ecological approach. Both of them we have studied. And there is another person, L.D. White and M. Dimock also. These are also associated with the ecological approach theory. So this is the brief. We have done this in very detail in our ecological approach session. So this is the very brief about it. So now we'll see what are the variants in ecological approach. So in universalist approach there were two variants. One was Wilson's model, another one was Weber's model. So in this ecological approach there are three variants. So first variant is general systems approach. So to give you a very brief idea of what systems approach is, we have dealt with this in our previous session also. I'll tell you which session. So what systems approach is, it is somewhat similar to ecological approach. Not somewhat, it is more like ecological approach. It says that there are two types of models. One is open model, one is closed model. So what is closed system model? Closed system model is something which does not interact with its environment, and open system model is something which interacts with its environment. So it is more or less ecological theory only, right? But ecological theory is very much or too much in detail. Systems model does not go in that much detail as ecological approach does. We have studied this in ecological approach that it is a too much of complex theory. It combines everything, diversity with complexity, formalism with change. So ecological approach jo hai wo kafi complex aur detailed hai, kafi in depth hai. But systems approach is similar to ecological approach, but it is not so in depth as ecological approach. It says that there are two models of every system. One is open system model, another one is closed system model. Closed system model will be closed, it will not interact with the society, and open system model will be open, it will interact with the society. So this is the brief about systems approach. Now in UPSC syllabus, where will you find systems approach? You will find this in module 4, that is theories of organization. You will find systems approach as one of the theory of organization, systems model as one of the theories of organization. Now an extension of systems model is cybernetic model. You will study about cybernetic model also in module 4 itself. So system model hota hai, uske andar hote hain open model and closed model, aur wo closed model open model ke alawa ek extension bhi hai systems model ka, usko बोलते हैं साइबरनेटिक मॉडल, वो भी मॉड्यूल 4 में आता है. एंड देयर इज अनदर मॉड्यूल व्हिच इज पब्लिक पॉलिसी मॉड्यूल, उसके अंदर एक ब्लैक बॉक्स मॉडल आता है, एंड दिस ब्लैक बॉक्स मॉडल इज आल्सो अ वेरिएंट ऑफ सिस्टम्स मॉडल. सो आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट फोर थिंग्स. वन इज मॉड्यूल 4 इन व्हिच यू फाइंड सिस्टम्स मॉडल एंड साइबरनेटिक मॉडल. सिस्टम्स मॉडल के अंदर होता है ओपन एंड क्लोज मॉडल, और साइबरनेटिक मॉडल इज नथिंग बट एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ सिस्टम्स मॉडल. सो दिस यू विल फाइंड इन मॉड्यूल 4. एंड इन पब्लिक पॉलिसी मॉड्यूल यू विल फाइंड अ ब्लैक बॉक्स मॉडल व्हिच इज अ वेरिएंट ऑफ सिस्टम्स मॉडल. And also also we have studied about systems model in brief in our previous module also in module 2 when we discussed about Chester Bernard. If you do not remember, please go and study the notes on the app which is there. When we were critically evaluating Chester Bernard, during those critical evaluation we were discussing significance of Chester Bernard, and while we were discussing significance we have discussed how Chester Bernard gave us an open model. So this is we have studied in Chester Bernard. So systems model is something which you will find all over the UPSC syllabus. ठीक है, काफी फैला हुआ है. मॉड्यूल 2 में भी है, मॉड्यूल 7 में हम पढ़ रहे हैं अभी, मॉड्यूल 4 में भी आएगा, पब्लिक पॉलिसी मॉड्यूल में भी आएगा. तो सिस्टम्स अप्रोच इज समथिंग विच इज क्वाइट स्प्रेड आउट ऑल ओवर द सिलेबस. सो यू विल फाइंड इट इन ऑलमोस्ट एवरीथिंग दैट यू स्टडी. सो इन इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच ऑल्सो देर इज अ सिस्टम्स अप्रोच. सिस्टम्स अप्रोच इन स्टडी ऑफ अबेट केम इन वोग इन 1960s. This approach envisages that a system consists of various subsystems which are in constant interaction with each other. तो कोई भी आप सिस्टम लोगे उसके अंदर various subsystem होंगे और ये जो various subsystem है ये एक दूसरे के interaction में रहेंगे. This is nothing but systems model. Very simple, right? A system consists of various subsystems और ये जो subsystems हैं ये एक दूसरे से interact करते हैं. This is nothing but systems model. When this systems approach is applied in study of public administration, it considers an administrative system as a subsystem within the larger social system and studies its interactions with the economic, social, political and cultural subsystems. तो अगर आप systems approach को public administration में लेके आओगे, तो how can you apply systems approach in public administration? You say that there is an overall social system. एक society होती है, right? तो वो society को आप बोलोगे एक overall जो है umbrella type का एक larger social system है. And inside that social system there are various subsystems. One is administrative subsystem, then there is economic subsystem, social subsystem, political subsystem, कल्चरल सबसिस्टम. तो ये सारे सब सिस्टम्स हैं विद इन द लार्जर सोशल सिस्टम. ठीक है, तो सोशल सिस्टम के अंदर ये सारे सब सिस्टम हैं एंड दीज सब सिस्टम्स इंटरेक्ट विद ईच अदर. दिस इज व्हाट इज नथिंग बट सिस्टम्स थियरी इन पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, दैट अ सिस्टम कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ वेरियस सब सिस्टम्स एंड दीज सब सिस्टम्स आर इन कॉन्स्टेंट इंटरेक्शन विद ईच अदर. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. दिस इज वेरी सिंपल, यू हैव नथिंग टू वरी अबाउट इट. व्हेन यू विल एक्चुअली स्टडी इट इन मॉड्यूल 4 यू विल फाइंड दिस वेरी सिंपल. दिस सिस्टम्स अप्रोच इज नाउ बीइंग वाइडली यूज्ड इन organization analysis. It has become very famous now. Systems approach is very famous today. It is particularly relevant to the study of complex public organization that have elaborate structures interacting with external environment. तो अगर आपको public organizations को study करना है तो उसमें ये काफी काम आता है, काफी useful होता है. When you have to study public organizations that have elaborate structures that interact with society, तो आप उस चीज को study करने के लिए systems approach use कर सकते हो. F.W. Ricks used the systems approach in the study of CPA. So we are listening this from the first session of comparative public administration itself, that F.W. Ricks used the ecological approach, right? तो ecological approach के अंदर F.W. Ricks ने क्या use किया? Systems approach. We know that F.W. Ricks used ecological approach, right? We know this. So what did he use within the ecological approach? Within the ecological approach, he used systems approach. So this is nothing but systems approach. This is the first model within the ecological approach. अभी दूसरा है development oriented approach. Now this is something which you study again when you study development administration module. And as I have said in my previous session also, that development administration and comparative public administration, these two modules or these two studies go hand in hand. दोनों साथ ही में rise हुए, दोनों साथ ही में evolve हुए और दोनों साथ साथ जाते हैं. तो आप CPA में भी development administration पढ़ोगे और आप development administration में भी CPA पढ़ोगे, वहाँ पे भी आपको Fred W. Ricks और वो सब पढ़ना पड़ेगा. So they both go hand in hand. So this is nothing but our development administration thing, which is nothing but development oriented approach. And this is very simple, an approach which focuses on development of lesser developed countries. जो lesser developed and अंडर डेवलप कंट्रीज होते हैं उनको डेवलप करने का ये अप्रोच है एंड नथिंग एल्स. दिस इज वेरी सिंपल. दिस अप्रोच इज कंसर्न्ड विद द स्टडी ऑफ डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज आवर नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल व्हिच इज नथिंग बट मॉड्यूल 8. डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में भी डिफाइंड एज गवर्नमेंट इंड्यूस्ड सोशियो इकोनॉमिक चेंज इन द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. तो डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज में जो गवर्नमेंट चेंजेस लेके आती हैं उसको बोलते हैं डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. इट हैज द पर्पस ऑफ मेकिंग चेंज फॉर गुड सोसाइटी. तो आपको सोसाइटी को बेहतर बनाना है, यू हैव टू वर्क फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ द सोसाइटी, दैट इज नथिंग बट development administration. It focuses on the capacity of administrative system to direct and adapt to such change. तो आपको ये change जो भी हो रहा है development के लिए, जो भी change हो रहा है society में, उसके साथ आप कितना adapt कर सकते हो, ये भी development administration जो है वो study देखती है. So this is nothing but development oriented approach. This approach has attracted scholars of CPA seeking ways and means to improve administrative performance and to strengthen the planning and execution of developmental programs. तो developmental programs जो होते हैं third world countries में, developing countries में, under developed countries में, उन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज़ को स्ट्रेंथन करने के लिए और उनको इम्प्रूव करने के लिए, उनकी परफॉर्मेंस आउटकम और वो सब बढ़ाने के लिए सीपीएस स्कॉलर्स ने ये अप्रोच की तरफ ध्यान दिया। एंड दिस इज हाउ डेवलपमेंट ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच केम टू बी वन ऑफ द इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोचेस ऑफ सीपीए। एडवर्ड वीडनर, यू विल स्टडी अबाउट ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मॉड्यूल, एंड दिस पर्सन इज द मेन प्रोपोनेंट ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच एंड ही यूज दिस मॉडल ऑफ सीपीए इन डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। यू विल स्टडी अबाउट ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। सो दिस इज आर सेकंड अप्रोच। फर्स्ट वॉज सिस्टम्स अप्रोच, सेकंड वॉज डेवलपमेंट ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच, थर्ड अप्रोच इन इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच इज फ्रेड डब्ल्यू रिक्स अप्रोच। नाउ यू विल फाइंड मेनी बुक्स एंड मेनी स्कॉलर्स सेइंग दैट दिस इज नॉट अ डिफरेंट अप्रोच, यू कैन पुट दिस अंडर सिस्टम्स अप्रोच ऑल्सो, बट वॉट आई हैव डन इज आई हैव पुट इट आउटसाइड। वी आर स्टडिंग इट एज अ थर्ड अप्रोच बिकॉज इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वेरियस थिंग्स। एज यू कैन सी, रिक्स प्रिज्मेटिक्स वाला मॉडल इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच, स्ट्रक्चरल फंक्शनल अप्रोच एंड हिज आइडियल मॉडल्स विच ही ब्रॉट अबाउट। वी विल स्टडी अबाउट आइडियल मॉडल्स इन आर नेक्स्ट सेशन। सो नेक्स्ट सेशन वी विल स्टडी अबाउट आइडियल मॉडल्स एंड वी स्टडी अबाउट फ्रेड डब्ल्यू रिक्स। सो दिस इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वेरियस थिंग्स। एक तो इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच यूज होता ही है। इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच में कौन सा अप्रोच? वी हैव सीन इन अबव पॉइंट, इट इज सिस्टम्स अप्रोच। ही यूज सिस्टम्स अप्रोच, राइट? सो ही यूज इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच, ही यूज स्ट्रक्चरल फंक्शनल अप्रोच ऑल्सो एंड ही यूज आइडियल मॉडल्स ऑल्सो एंड दिस इज द कॉम्बिनेशन दैट ही यूज्ड टू अराइव एट द प्रिज्मेटिक साला मॉडल। सो दिस मॉडल आई कंसिडर एज द थर्ड अप्रोच ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल मॉडल। सो वी आर डन विद मॉडल्स, द जनरल मॉडल्स वी आर डन विद। वी विल स्टडी सम अदर मॉडल्स विच डू नॉट फॉल ऑन टू दिस कैटेगरी ऑफ यूनिवर्सलिस्ट एंड इकोलॉजिकल। तो हमने दो बेसिक टर्मिनोलॉजीज पढ़ी। वन वॉज यूनिवर्सलिस्ट अप्रोच विच इज यूनिवर्सल इन नेचर। देर वर टू विद इन दैट, विल्सन्स मॉडल एंड वेबर्स मॉडल। एंड देन वी स्टडीड अबाउट इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच। इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच इज कंसर्नड विद द इंटरकनेक्शंस ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड इट्स सोसाइटी। उसके अंदर आते हैं तीन। फर्स्ट इज सिस्टम्स मॉडल, सेकंड इज डेवलपमेंट ओरिएंटेड मॉडल एंड थर्ड इज रिग्स प्रिज्मेटिक्स वाला मॉडल विच वी विल स्टडी अबाउट व्हेन वी स्टडी फ्रेड डब्ल्यू रिग्स। सो दिस वी आर डन विद टू बेसिक अप्रोचेस गिवन बाय रमेश के अरोरा। नाउ वी विल स्टडी सम अदर मॉडल्स, अ फ्यू मॉडल्स, थ्री मॉडल्स वी विल स्टडी विच डू नॉट एग्जैक्टली फॉल इन टू दीज कैटेगरीज ऑफ यूनिवर्सलिस्ट एंड इकोलॉजिकल। तो कहीं ना कहीं बीच में फॉल होते हैं वो। वी विल स्टडी अबाउट देम। So first is Downs model. We have already studied about Downs model when we were studying public choice approach. I hope you remember Anthony Downs model. Public choice approach में हमने Anthony Downs model पढ़ा है। We'll study how Downs model is used in comparative public administration now. So going ahead with it, central assumption of this model is rational administrative agencies will tend to be imperialistic in nature, competing with one another for space. So what do you mean by imperialistic? Imperialism means when you are trying to expand your area of influence, ठीक है? And for example, colonization is a one way by which you achieve imperialism, right? आप colonize करते हो nations को, British had colonized India, so colonization is one way by which you achieve imperialism. Imperialism is expanding your area of influence. So in context of public administration, what does imperialism mean now? Anthony Downs says that rational administrative agencies, जो legal rational type of agencies होती हैं, जो we have studied about what rational models are, right? Rational models or traditional models, जो खाली rules or principles driven होते थे, जो बोलते थे कि सब कुछ रैशनल रैशनल होना चाहिए, रैशनलिटी होनी चाहिए सब कुछ, तो सच रैशनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव एजेंसीज विल टेंड टू बी इंपीरियलिस्टिक। दिस इज व्हाट एंथनी डाउन्स सेज। ही सेज दैट दीज एजेंसीज विल ट्राई टू एक्सपांड देयर एरिया ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस, कंपीटिंग विद वन अनदर फॉर स्पेस। According to Anthony Downs, every social agent is essentially a territorial imperialist. So, social agent, what do you mean by social agent? Social agent, among other things, are bureaucrats and administrators. So, these are the examples of social agent. And there are many social agents, but these are the examples of social agent which are concerned with us. ठीक है, हमारे studies related जो हैं, वो हैं bureaucrats and administrators. And such bureaucrats and administrators, every such social agent is essentially a territorial imperialist. वो अपना area of influence बढ़ाने की कोशिश करते हैं हमेशा. This is what Anthony Downs says. He seeks to expand borders of his various zones and policy space, or at least to increase his degree of influence within each zone. So what does bureaucrat or social agent does? Anthony Downs says that he tries to increase his zone of policy space. ब्यूरोक्रेट्स का काम होता है पॉलिसी इंप्लीमेंटेशन, राइट? एंड व्हेन यू आर एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया, यू हैव एन इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर दैट एरिया। तो व्हाट एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर विल डू इज ही विल ट्राई टू इंक्रीज हिज इन्फ्लुएंस। सो ही विल ट्राई टू इंक्रीज द एरिया अंडर हिज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। सो दिस इज नथिंग बट अ फीचर ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट दैट एंथनी डाउन सेज दैट ही इज अ टेरिटोरियल इंपीरियलिस्ट। एवरी ब्यूरोक्रेट और एवरी एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर इज अ टेरिटोरियल इंपीरियलिस्ट। ही विल ट्राई टू इंक्रीज हिज इन्फ्लुएंशियल एरिया। जब वो कोई भी एरिया एडमिनिस्ट्रेट लेक्चर कर रहा होता है दैट मीन्स ही हैज इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर दैट एरिया राइट सो ही विल ट्राई टू इंक्रीज द एरिया दैट ही इज एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग सो दिस इज नथिंग बट वॉट एंथनी डाउन सेज एंड इन हिज बुक इनसाइड ब्यूरोक्रेसी वी हैव सीन दिस दैट ही गेव फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स क्लाइंबर्स कंजर्वर्स जीलर्स एडवोकेट्स एंड स्टेटमेंट्स वी हैव सीन दिस इन आर पब्लिक चॉइस अप्रोच सेशन व्हेन वी स्टडीड अबाउट पब्लिक चॉइस थियरी वी सॉ दैट ही गेव फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स एंड प्लीज गो बैक एंड वॉच देम इफ यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर दिस दीज आर द फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स दैट एंथनी डाउन्स गेव नाउ हाउ डू वी यूज दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंथनी डाउन्स इन कंपेयरिंग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन विल सी फर्दर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ईच ऑफ दिस पर्सनैलिटी टाइप्स डाउन्स आर्ग्यूड कुड लीड टू प्रेडिक्शन ऑन फॉर्म्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेटिक पॉलिटिक्स दैट वुड बी प्रैक्टिस्ड तो अगर आपको प्रेडिक्ट करना है किसी एरिया में ब्यूरोक्रेसी किस तरह काम करेगी तो आप इन पांच टाइप के ब्यूरोक्रेट्स को स्टडी करो व्हेन यू स्टडी दिस व्हेन यू फर्दर डेवलप ईच ऑफ दिस ब्यूरोक्रेट टाइप्स यू कम टू नो एंड यू कैन प्रेडिक्ट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेसी और एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वन एरिया विल हैव इन फ्यूचर सो दिस इज हाउ एंथनी डाउन सेड दैट फर्दर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ईच ऑफ दिस पर्सनैलिटी टाइप्स कुड लीड टू प्रेडिक्शन ऑन द फॉर्म्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेटिक पॉलिटिक्स दैट वुड बी प्रैक्टिस्ड डाउन्स थियरी इज यूजफुल टू डिस्क्राइब द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बिहेवियर ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तो ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड अगर आपको बिहेवियर कंपेयर करना है ब्यूरोक्रेट्स का तो आप डाउन्स मॉडल यूज कर सकते हो टू कंपेयर द बिहेवियर ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स ऑल ओवर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड सो दिस इज हाउ डाउन्स मॉडल इज यूजफुल इन आर कंपेरेटिव पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन डाउन्स डेवलप्ड अ लॉ ऑफ काउंटर कंट्रोल ही गेव दिस लॉ ऑफ काउंटर कंट्रोल ही सेड दैट द ग्रेटर द एफर्ट्स मेड बाय टॉप लेवल ऑफिशियल्स टू कंट्रोल द बिहेवियर ऑफ सबऑर्डिनेट ऑफिशियल्स द ग्रेटर एफर्ट्स मेड बाय दो सबऑर्डिनेट्स टू इवेड और काउंटरैक्ट सच कंट्रोल सो वेरी सिंपली दिस मींस दैट आप जितना अपने नीचे वाले एम्प्लॉयज को दबाने की कोशिश करोगे उतना ही वो रेजिस्ट करेंगे उस आपके दबाव का राइट सो आप जितना उनको दबाओगे उतना ही वो रेजिस्ट करेंगे दिस इज द लॉ ऑफ काउंटर कंट्रोल आप जितना उनको कंट्रोल करने की कोशिश करोगे उतना ही वो लोग आपके कंट्रोल को काउंटर करेंगे सो दिस इज द लॉ ऑफ काउंटर कंट्रोल गिवन बाय एंथनी डाउन्स एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट डाउन्स मॉडल इन रिलेशन टू कंपेरेटिव पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दिस इज हाउ इट इज यूज टू कंपेयर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड बिहेवियर ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर्स ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड दिस इज द अनदर मॉडल विच इज वी आर स्टडिंग आउटसाइड द यूनिवर्सलिस्ट और इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच दिस डज नॉट फॉल इन एनी ऑफ दिस राइट बिकॉज दिस एनालाइजेस द बिहेवियर इट गिव्स फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेट्स तो इट डज नॉट बेसिकली और एग्जैक्टली फॉल इन टू द यूनिवर्सलिस्ट और द इकोलॉजिकल अप्रोच सो मूविंग ऑन विद आर नेक्स्ट मॉडल नाउ डॉर्सीज इन्फॉर्मेशन एनर्जी मॉडल सो डॉर्सीज इन्फॉर्मेशन एनर्जी मॉडल इज बेस्ड ऑन अ सिंथेसिस ऑफ द कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ जनरल सिस्टम्स थियरी ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड साइबरनेटिक्स एंड एनर्जी कन्वर्जन सो वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट सिस्टम्स थियरी इज राइट जनरल सिस्टम्स थियरी हमने पढ़ी है एंड आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट साइबरनेटिक्स एज यू कैन सी दिस साइबरनेटिक्स मॉडल इज एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ सिस्टम्स थियरी विच यू विल स्टडी इन मॉड्यूल 4 दैट इज नथिंग बट थियरीज ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सो व्हाट डॉर्सी डिड वाज ही गेव वन इन्फॉर्मेशन एनर्जी मॉडल फॉर सीपीए ही गेव वन इन्फॉर्मेशन एनर्जी मॉडल फॉर सीपीए एंड he merged two systems theories one is cybernetic theory of which is nothing but communication and cybernetics theory of general systems theory and another is energy conversion theory which we do not study which is not in our scope of syllabus so do not worry about this we will never encounter so for the sake of just this model ye Dorsey ka information energy model samajhne ke liye aap samajh lo sirf itna ki systems theory ke do types ko merge kiya hai Dorsey ne one is cybernetic model another is energy conversion model and what this model is energy information model what this model is we'll study about this model but do not worry about this energy conversion model we do not have to worry about this so moving on with this model Dorsey's model conceptualizes individuals groups organizations and societies as complete information energy converters so ye jo bhi log hain individuals group organization ye jo bhi hain ye sab information energy converters hain what this means we'll see in our next points so do not worry but remember that these are information energy converters energy is defined as the ability to affect some change तो अगर आप कुछ चेंज कर सकते हो अगर आप में वो एबिलिटी है तो दैट एबिलिटी इज द एनर्जी एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट द एबिलिटी टू अफेक्ट सम चेंज अगर आप कुछ चेंज लाने की क्षमता है आप में तो क्षमता जो है दैट इज नथिंग बट योर एनर्जी एंड एनर्जी कन्वर्जन व्हाट डू मीन बाय एनर्जी कन्वर्जन इट इज नथिंग बट मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ दिस कैपेसिटी और द प्रोसेस ऑफ अफेक्टिंग सम चेंजेस तो एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट योर एबिलिटी और योर क्षमता राइट वो क्षमता के बेसिस पे अगर आप चेंज ला पा रहे हो एक्चुअली में अगर आपने चेंज ला दिया यू हैव कन्वर्टेड योर एनर्जी तो एनर्जी nothing but ability to make some change and energy conversion is nothing but when you are actually making some change you have converted your energy I hope this is clear energy is nothing but ability and actually making some change is nothing but conversion of that energy I hope this point is clear information we have seen what energy is now we'll see information can be viewed as energy in certain forms or configuration to kisi ek certain form mein agar aap energy ko leke aate ho to wo information ban jati hai we'll see see a system converts inputs such as demands and intelligence into outputs through various conversion process of screening, selecting and channelizing. And this is information. You are giving some inputs aur un inputs ke basis pe aap outputs nikalte ho through various processes. Converting into output is conversion of energy, right? So energy in a particular form, in a certain form or configuration of inputs is nothing but information. Agar aap usko inputs ki tarah doge to fir wo information ban jayega, that is nothing but energy, which is now information. So I hope this is clear to you. I hope I am being clear. Agar aapko clear nahi hai to aap please comments mein likhna. I'll try to make it more clear in words. So energy is defined as the ability to make some change. Energy conversion is actually making that change. Information is a particular kind of energy. Ek certain form mein agar aap us energy ko doge to wo information ban jati hai, which is nothing but inputs. Theek hai, agar aap inputs ko output mein convert kar rahe ho, you are actually giving information jiski wajah se output aa raha hai. Theek hai, to information is energy in certain forms or configurations. So what this model is, humne dekh liya energy kya hai, humne dekh liya information kya hai. Now what actually this model is, information energy model kya hai, his basic hypothesis is that a society's degree of development is a measure of information and energy surplus. To kisi bhi society mein kitna surplus hai energy ka aur information ka, uske basis pe aap bata sakte ho society kitni developed hai. This is how you can compare administrations across the world, whether they are developed administration or developing administration. You can tell if there are surplus energy and information in that system or in that society. I hope it is being clear to you how it is a comparative administration model. Developing nations administrative systems usually face scarcity of information input, storage and processing. To jo developing nation hote hain unke administrative system mein scarcity hoti hai information ki, input ki, storage ki aur processing ki. To as we have already seen, degree of development is nothing but kitna surplus hai. Aur agar surplus nahi hai to aap developing ho, agar scarcity hai to aap developing ho. This results in relatively smaller energy outputs. Agar aapka scarcity hogi, surplus nahi hoga, scarcity hogi, to this results in relatively smaller energy outputs, which in turn results in an ineffective administrative process, conservatism and lack of rationality. Fir agar aapke paas agar scarcity hogi, information nahi hai, energy nahi hai agar aapke administrative system mein, is model ke hisab se agar aapke system mein surplus nahi hai, it will result in smaller energy output. To jo output honge wo bhi chote chote output honge, and this will result in ineffective administrative process. Fir aapki administration jo hai wo inefficient and ineffective ho jayegi, and it will lead to conservatism. Fir aap progressive nahi rahoge, fir aap conservative ban jaoge, kyunki aapke paas information ka surplus hi nahi hai, right? To fir wo conservatism ki taraf aapko bada dega, and lack of rationality. So this is all what that happens when there is no surplus of information and energy. Since his approach views administrative system in the context of their environment, it is essentially ecological but not exactly ecological. Lekin agar aapko fir bhi agar generally kisi mein place karna hai to aap ecological approach mein Dorsey ke model ko place kar sakte ho, but exactly wo ecological approach fir bhi nahi hai, but still it is an ecological to a sense that hum dekh rahe hain ki input aa raha hai, energy information aa rahi hai, right? To information society deti hai na, to it is essentially ecological. Ek tarike se ecological hi hai. Agar aapko kahin pe generally place karna hai to aap ecological mein is model ko place kar sakte ho, but actually it does not qualify as an exact ecological model. However, according to Berenson, this model was a total failure in explaining the bureaucratic changes in third world countries. So, developing countries ko compare karne ke liye Dorsey ne bola ki agar surplus nahi hai to fir developing country hai, surplus hai to developed country hai, right? But Berenson, he is another thinker, Berenson said that it is a total failure when we try to explain the bureaucratic changes that happen in third world countries. Fir usko ye explain nahi kar pata hai. This is nothing but Dorsey's information energy model in context of our comparative administration. I hope this is clear to you, and we'll move on to our last model of today, which is nothing but Mathur's model. Mathur is an Indian thinker. By the name you might have guessed it. And Mathur, in his study, analyzed block development officers of India, BDO जो होते हैं इंडिया के, उनको analyze किया माथुर ने, of two different states in India. Now I did not find information on which two states he studied about. Maybe I did not look enough, but if you find any information on which two states he studied about, you can write that in comments. So basically Mathur in his study analyzed BDOs of India of two different states. Before the analysis, he first clearly identified, sorry for the spelling mistake, he first clearly identified certain geographical, socio-economic and political factors which present a different background for the BDOs of the two states. तो ये जो BDOs हैं दो states के जिनको माथुर ने analyze किया, इन दो states के BDOs के लिए माथुर ने बहुत सारे factors बना लिए. Analysis करने से पहले बहुत सारे factors बना लिए, and these are nothing but political factors, economic factors and geographical, socio-economical. ये जो different background होते हैं BDOs के, उनको analyze करने के लिए बहुत सारे factor बना लिए before analyzing them. This is what माथुर did. Mathur's model employs factor analysis technique. Now, factors analysis technique is very simple. He had developed various factors before analyzing, right? Before the analysis, he came up with various factors. And then what he did was, he analyzed these factors. And this is nothing but factor analysis technique. He analyzed certain factors. This is nothing but factor analysis technique. By using this technique, Mathur developed the major dimension of bureaucratic thinking and perceptions. So, bureaucratic thinking or perceptions ko analyze kiya Mathur ne apne factor analysis technique se. So, this is nothing but Mathur's model. His aim is to establish an empirical pattern of reactions of bureaucrats to the changing environment. तो जो भी bureaucrats होते हैं उनका changing environment को क्या reaction है वो capture करने की कोशिश की माथुर ने. As you can see, his focus was bureaucratic thinking and perceptions and reactions of bureaucrats to the changing environment. तो किस तरह से सोचते हैं अगर environment change हो रही है, society change हो रही है तो उनका क्या reaction होता है. तो ये सब माथुर ने compare किया दो states के साथ and this is how he developed his model using the factor analysis technique. And this is significant for micro level aspect of comparative public administration. We have studied different levels of CPA, right? One is macro level CPA, another is micro level CPA, which is within the country, and the third one is cross temporal, which cuts across time, if you remember. So micro level aspect agar aapko study karna hai to Mathur's model bahut hi acha hai. It is significant for micro level and this is very evident also, right? Mathur ne kya kiya, those states ko compare kiya, those states ke BDOs ko compare kiya. So this is very evident that his model is effective and significant for micro level aspect of CPA. This model, if rightly used, could furnish an insight into politics and bureaucracy and the perceptions and attitudes of the officials at every level of administration in relation to their work, motivational factors, and in evaluating the morale of the employees at every level of administration. तो हर level of administration पे आप उनके behavior, उनके morale, उनके perceptions, उनके thinking, उनके insight, उनके attitude, हर चीज को आप compare कर सकते हो by using Mathur's model. So this is how Mathur's model is significant for micro level aspect of CPA. I hope this is clear to you. We have studied different models of CPA today. This was the last model. Two general approaches we have studied given by Ramesh Arora. Ramesh Arora gave two general approaches of universalist approach and ecological approach. Under universalist approach you will find Wilson's model and Weber's model. Under ecological approach you will find systems approach, development oriented approach and Ricks prismatic sala model. So prismatic sala model we'll study when we study about Fred W. Ricks. So that is there. And other than that we studied three different models. First was Downs model given by Anthony Downs. Another is Dorsey's information energy model. I hope that was clear to you. If it is not clear to you, please mention it in the comments. And third one is Mathur's model, which is significant for micro level aspect of comparative public administration. So I hope these approaches or these models are clear to you. And in the next session, we'll stop the session today. In the next session, we'll study about Fred W. Ricks and his models of agraria industria, fused prismatic and diffracted society and all those things. We'll study that in our next session. So please subscribe to the channel if you do not want to miss the next session. Like and comment on the video if you like the content. Also share the video if you like the content that I have given today. Hope to see you soon in my next session. Peace out.